Arabs in the Philippines, Wikipedia article audio. According to Philippine Ambassador to Jordan, Juniver M. Mahilam West, in 2016 an estimated 2% of the population of the Philippines, about 2 million people, could claim partial Arab ancestry. Arab traders have been visiting Philippines for nearly 2,000 years for trade purposes, and traded extensively with local Malayan chiefs, datos and rajas that had various rajinats in the region. Arab and Persian traders passed by the Philippines, on their way to Guangzhou, China. These early Arab traders followed the pre-Islamic religions of Arabian Christianity, paganism and Sabinism. After the advent of Islam, in 1380, Karim al-Maktum, the first Islamic missionary to reach the Sulu archipelago, brought Islam to what is now the Philippines, first arriving in Jolo. Subsequent visits of Arab Muslim missionaries strengthened the Islamic faith in the Philippines, concentrating in the south and reaching as far north as Manila. Starting with the conquest of Malaysia by the Portuguese and Indonesia by the Dutch, the Philippines began to receive a number of Malaysian Arab refugees, including several Malaysian princes and displaced court advisors. Soon, vast sultanates were established overlapping the existing indigenous Filipino barangay governing system and Indianized royalty. The two largest were the Sultanate of Maguindanao, which loosely governed most of southern Mindanao, and the Sultanate of Sulu, which included Basilan, Jolo, and parts of Borneo. Several other smaller but famous sultanates were also established, such as the Sultanate of Lanao and Mindanao, which was later conquered by the Spanish in the 16th century. The ties between the sultanates and Mindanao remained economically and culturally close to Indonesia, Brunei, and Malaysia until the end of the 19th century, when the sultanates were weakened by the Spanish and later the American militaries. According to the Syrian consulate in Makati, the first Orthodox Christians on the islands were Syrian and Lebanese merchants and sailors, who arrived in Manila after the city was opened to international trade. Many of the Lebanese sailors married local women, and their descendants have since become Philippine citizens, including the owners of a famous pizzeria in Manila. In recent times, the first wave of Arabs to arrive to the Philippines were refugees from their war-torn nations, such as Lebanon, which was under civil war in the 1980s, and Arab nations involved with the Gulf War in 1991. Other Arabs are entrepreneurs who intend to set up businesses. Present-day Arab Filipino families include the Benayras, the Usman bin Husayfans from Hadramaut, the Abubakars, the Bajuanids, and the Samanidas of Jolo, Lanao, Cotabato and Maguindanao. In the early 1900s, Tuan Guru Muhammad Ali Samanodi arrived in the Philippines. He taught Islam in the provinces of Sulu, Taytay, Maguindanao and Lanao. He married Dayang Dayang Siti Sagarilaja Basil Maulana, a descendant of the Kirims of the Sulu Sultanate. They had as children Datu Sali L. Samanodi, Datu Usman L. Samanodi and Dayang Dayang Siti Jane Samanodi Maulana. One of their grandchildren is Pudli Suharani C. Samanodi, who married former RMM Governor Datu Zakaria A. Candeo, descendant of Datu Pulalantop, Raja Muta of Samui and member of the Maguindanao Sultanate. Tuan Guru Samanodi also married Haja Siti Zubeda Yakub. His other wives were Halima and Zainab, both of the Maranao descent. Former ARMM speaker Ismail Pachang Abubakar is a Badiri from his maternal side and an Abubakar from his paternal side. Former MSU Gansan Chancellor Monar Bajuanade is of Arab descent. The Ampachuans of Maguindanao descended from an Arab preacher named Sheriff Saidona Mustafa. He arrived in Maguindanao around 1478-79 and married a Maguindanaoan woman and had a son. The Masukat, Mangakop, Sankey and the Buzan clans all descended from Saidona Mustafa. The Masturas, meanwhile, descended from Sheriff Kabunsuan, an Arab Malay prince from Johor. The Solomons of Cotabato City are among the Arab pioneers and migrated to the then town of Cotabato to start a new life. First coming to the Philippines through Bacolod City, then Katipunan in North Cotabato, and finally to Cotabato City. The Solomons settled in Cotabato City and became prominent in business. Jack Jacob Ant Solomon Yakab Ant Nishiwet was born in Al Salt, Jordan. He used to own a bazaar and barber shop in Magallanes Street in Cotabato City. He was a respected figure among the city's vast Muslim community. The Nishiwet family of Al Salt, to which the Solomon family descended from, are among the oldest family in Jordan and can be traced back as early as 14th century. the Nishiwot still exist in Al Salt, which was recently declared a protected area by Queen Rania of Jordan. Jack Solomon had three wives, of whom he had six children. The eldest being Chirito Solomon Bueno, a respected academician and professor of Notre Dame University, married to Damaso Bueno Sr. and had four children, namely Damaso Jr., Ma, Donna, Jack Thomas and Emmanuel. Then followed by Dr. Joseph A. Ed Solomon, a neurosurgeon married to Dr. Ella Sutton Solomon, based in Baltimore, Maryland, United States, and had three children, Jack Joseph, Pamela and Michael. Nelson A. Ed Solomon, a retired banker of Philippine National Bank, married to Sylvia Garcing, a daughter of one of Cotabato City's pioneer Vicente Garcing of Victorias, Negros, and had three children, namely Jacqueline, Jack Vincent and Judah. Miriam Solomon Anino, a chemical engineer married to Dr. Rolando Anino, had three children, namely Lovell and Grace, Jack Rollin and Rolando Jr. Jack Solomon Jr., a mariner, and Gamal Solomon, married to Janet Flores, with four boys, Jack Christopher, Jan Paolo, Gian Gamaliel and Jairo Angelo. The Solomons of today have left Cotabato for good. Bajas of Zamboanga, Makmat of Cotabato and General Santos. Palestinian wives of noted Islamic scholars from the Pasigan family of Maguindanao and Davao. Also of Arab descent in Mindanao are the following families. In the Visayas, the Karam family of Iloilo, the Dean and Jaridini families from Cebu are of Arab descent. The historian Caesar Adib Majil was the son of a Greek Orthodox Christian immigrant from Syria. He became a prominent historian on the Muslim Moro people in the history of Islam in the Philippines and wrote many books about Moros and Islam. He converted to Islam during adulthood. Of Lebanese origin are the Nasser and Borghali families of Davao City and the Ismail family of New Manila. From Tagaytay, Cagayan Valley are the Abrahams, whose original family name was Fakhri, who were blood relations of the Maronite Catholic Saint Charbel from Lebanon. The Christian Arab American Dr. Najib Mitri Salibi, who was born in Ottoman Lebanon in 1870, emigrated to America, served as a medic in the American Army, and was sent to the Philippines, where he became superintendent of schools in the Moro province. He co-owned a house with the Lebanese Maronite immigrant John Awad in Davao in Mindanao, but unlike Awad, Salibi does not appear to have stayed in the Philippines and instead returned to America, as he has no descendants in the Philippines. Dr. Salibi became a historian on the Moro people and their sultanates after learning their languages and wrote several books on their history. Salibi died in 1935. The forebear of the Awad family of Davao is the Lebanese Maronite Christian John Awad, who hailed from the Bica Valley. In the 1880s, Awad converted some Muslims around Davao to Christianity. Some movie and TV celebrities are also of Arab descent. Among them are Carlos Agassi, Charlie Davao, Don Zuluta, Kula Desma, Ana Rosas, Uma County, Yasmin Curdy, Jesse Mendiola, Mona Louise Rhee, and her older sister Ivana Oloi.